And only afternoon, how are you?
Afternoon, yeah, good.
A good week?
Good week, okay. At the end I will tell you tomorrow. Normally the weeks depend on what happens on the weekend, and let's see tomorrow.
Well, it's been a good couple of weeks, that win against Arsenal, the draw against Aston Villa. How much confidence does your squad have right now?
No, I don't think it's about confidence. It's about preparing as good as we can the game against City, knowing that it's going to be a really difficult one, considering the opposition, but trying to give us chances. Give us chances. I think the game we played here past season can be a good reference for us. They beat us 1-0, but I think we played quite well, and we have to be very similar or even better to have any chance against them, yes.
Bournemouth don't have a victory against Manchester City. I don't know if you know that coming into this game.
No, I know, everyone repeats here. We don't even have a point, no, in the Premier League, I think. It's 14 games, 14 losses, no? There is a reason. And they also this year, they are unbeaten in the Premier League, top of the table. It's difficult not only for Bournemouth, it's difficult for everyone. But we have to play against them twice a season, so we have to maximize our options, give our best, and see if it's enough. Yeah.
Well, Pep Guardiola says he hasn't got any players, so he's only got 13 to choose from. Does that make this a prime opportunity for Bournemouth to get that win?
No, they come in a really good place, I think football-wise, results-wise, top of the table, unbeaten. I think they haven't lost a game in 2024 in the Premier League. That is, we are already in November, so it's really amazing. And they have some injuries. These top teams, they are playing every 3-4 days. Sometimes it's very difficult, I'm sure, for them to play every 3-4 days. But we also have some injuries, and I will care in this case of the ones we have, more of the ones they have, because I think from the team we faced here, the starting 11 they put, I think apart from Rodri, I don't know if anyone else is injured, but most of them are available, yeah.
In terms of your own injuries, of course, no Kepa last week, or Philip Billing, or Luis Sinisterra. What's an update with those players?
Yeah, I think apart from Alex, that is a long-term injury that he will be out for more time. Kepa will not be available against the City. Luis Sinisterra will not be available. Philip Billing, yes, because it was an illness. So after 2-3 days feeling poorly, he has been training normal with the team, and I think it's very unlikely also to have Dango, because he felt something yesterday, and I don't want to say 100%, but I see very, very difficult that he also is involved tomorrow, yes.
No Kepa, but Mark Travers was excellent last week. How much of a spring in his step has he had this week?
No, it's not a surprise for us. We know the level Mark has. I think This season, I think even the first games with Neto, then with Kepa, Mark has been also involved in against Chelsea, against Villa. I think overall the position has been quite solid, and this is what they all have to do. The end is not a matter of just I play, you play. No. It's all the goalkeepers are giving us a very good level, whoever is the one starting, and I hope we can continue, no, with this same level, yes.
There's a new manager in the Premier League today. I don't know if you've heard the news. Ruben Amorim is the new Manchester United manager. Is he someone you've come across during your career so far?
No, I haven't. I have never played against him, and obviously I've seen some games on TV, but I cannot say a lot about him, no.
In terms of being a new manager coming into the Premier League, what advice would you have for him for adapting to this league?
Advice for sure. They have better references in their club and very experienced people there in United to give advice better than me, no? For sure, he arrives to a big club because he has been really, really successful in the previous clubs, in Braga, in Sporting, and for sure he has the level, and I cannot give him any advice in this way.
Thanks, Antonio.
Thank you.
Thank you. You mentioned the game here last year. I know you've had some big wins, but that performance, how highly does that rate, especially the second half?
For me, it's one of the best games probably we played past season. We lost that game, but I felt like we put them under pressure. We performed really well individually. We had very difficult duels. I think they were better than us in the first half, but I think we were, I don't know if better, but as good at least in the second half, but they still beat us 1-0. So it makes you think, no, the level of the performance, even if it's very good for us, it hasn't been enough to beat them, even to take a point against them. So we have to be even better, yes.
Have you watched that game back this week? Are there things you can take from that?
Yeah, I normally watch last game we played against every opposition, especially if they haven't changed a lot of players or the manager, or normally we always watch that game, but I think it's going to be different tactically. We will do different things, they will do different things. It's already, I don't know, 6-7 months, you know, have passed, so we've lost also some players that played that game, that we will have another ones. It's not going to be the same, no.
The recent results in the Premier League have all been quite tight. They've always got over the line, but are they, from the performances as you've analysed them, are the results reflective? Are they as dominant and comfortable as they have been in previous months and seasons?
I think they control the games, and they choose sometimes when to push harder, when to control more the game, when to rest on the ball sometimes. If they feel the need, they have normally one more year than the opposition, and they have done it so consistently for so much time, you know, that it's because they are very good and they know what they are doing. And we try to find ways, every team differently, and trying to make them make mistakes or don't play so comfortably, but it's very difficult. It's very, very difficult.
So it's very easy to say, but is disrupting them, sort of making them less, I don't know, able to just control and making them think about getting into those next gears, is that, you know, not making it chaotic, but perhaps putting them, making them uncomfortable?
I think they are very good both sides, because if you leave space behind, they also exploit very well the space. They have, obviously, if you leave Haaland one against one all the time alone behind your line, normally he will punish you. It's true that if you don't go, you will not see the ball all the game. They are very good, and they are very good not only on the ball, not only attacking the spaces, they are very good overall. So you have to choose a little bit. You will need to, sometimes it's a matter of choosing the poison, no? You want to die like this, you want to die like this. It's difficult. We will try to choose the best option for us, that we think, but it's not gonna be easy, for sure.
I realize you only played 10-15 minutes, but has Tyler reacted well to coming on last week?
Yeah, he's training really well. Very confident, he looks very confident, and I think obviously knowing that he has only played 15-20 minutes in the last months, but I see him in a very good spot, yes.
Julian Araujo's been taken off at half time and then half an hour last week. How's he reacted to that?
Very well. I think he has reacted very well. I think he has a very good mentality. He trains very well. He wants to improve. He knows that he's coming to a new league, and he needs to get a lot of things very quickly. And I like his approach. I like his approach. He knows he's not now the finished product, you know. He's still developing. Luckily for him, he's very young, and he has to improve a lot of things, but I think he's training very well, and I like how he has taken the decision, yes.
and I know City are strong everywhere, but down their left-hand side with whether it's Nunez or Doku, but then Guardiola coming up as well, I wondered if you put Dango that side to help with the defensive side. How big a blow is it that he's now a doubt?
It's a big blow for us, because especially considering that Sini also is out, and we always, not always, but normally 95% of the time we change both wingers, and we need after normally after, I don't know, 60, 65, 70, 50 sometimes, we need a change of pace, and if Dango starts or opposite, it doesn't matter where, but we will miss with Dango and Sini, because both are very good wingers, very difference makers, I would say, in one against one situations. But the same way, City will have to adapt because they have some injuries. We will have to adapt also because we have some injuries, and that's the reason we have the squads we have, and we will try to be still competitive. But it's true that I would prefer to have them, yes.
Of course. Well, good luck.
Yeah, thank you.